Bank of America, one of the worst performing bank stocks this year, down about 17%.
That has an interesting impact. If you have a lot of zero interest funds, the rates coming down don't help.
Bank of America, a major player in the financial world, has issued a troubling warning about the possibility of a severe financial crisis. They are concerned about the growing number of toxic assets, which they believe could severely damage the U.S. financial system and have widespread effects on the global economy. This warning comes at a time when the world is still recovering from the COVID-19 pandemic and suffering from geopolitical tensions and economic instability. It emphasizes the need for urgent action to prevent a potential disaster of unprecedented scale. Today, we will analyze Bank of America's warning and way forward. Toxic assets, the hidden menace. The major reason for this warning is a complicated network of toxic assets. This term is closely associated with the financial chaos that occurred in 2008. Toxic assets refer to financial instruments that have lost significant value and are difficult or impossible to sell or generate returns from. These assets include subprime mortgages, intricate derivatives, corporate debt, and government bonds, all carrying a significant risk. Unfortunately, this risk was either underestimated or hidden by unclear accounting practices and regulatory loopholes. The accumulation of these toxic assets was attributed to several factors, such as relaxed lending standards, high levels of borrowing, and a strong desire for high-yield investments during a period of historically low interest rates. Financial institutions, eager to generate profits and stay competitive, embraced increasingly intricate and risky financial products, often without fully understanding the potential long-term consequences. When multiple banks and financial institutions hold toxic assets, their potential collapse can have a domino effect, destabilizing the entire financial system. Understanding the factors behind Bank of America's grave concerns. Bank of America's recent warning about an upcoming financial disaster has sent shockwaves through the banking industry and beyond. The alarm is not just about a potential downturn, but rather an incoming crisis that could bring the entire U.S. banking system to its knees. To understand the gravity of the situation, we need to rewind to the global financial crisis of 2008, a time when toxic assets nearly crushed both the U.S. and global financial systems. Fast forward to today, and these toxic assets are back, even bigger than before. The main issue revolves around commercial real estate loans, which Bank of America's CEO, Brian Moynihan, describes as a slow burn that could turn into an inferno. Historically, commercial real estate prices have either risen steadily or remained fairly stable. However, the environment has changed dramatically due to the pandemic. With remote work becoming more prevalent, office spaces are sitting empty, and the demand for commercial real estate is decreasing. This shift has led to a surge in failures on commercial real estate loans, signaling trouble for the banking sector. To make matters worse, rising interest rates have slashed the value of assets on banks' books, resulting in hundreds of billions of dollars in unrealized losses. The inversion of yield curves further complicates matters, tightening financial conditions and discouraging lending. Instead of capitalizing on lending opportunities, banks are hoarding cash, fearing further losses. The repercussions of these trends are already being felt across the banking industry, with several regional lenders experiencing financial disruption and even collapse. New York Community Bank's recent need for a cash infusion due to property loan troubles is a clear example of the worsening situation. Moreover, the creation and trading of toxic assets reminiscent of those that caused the 2008 crisis are deepening the problem. Commercial real estate collateralized loan obligations, CRCLOs, similar to the mortgage-backed securities of the past, are facing unusual stress as borrowers struggle to repay loans tied to commercial property ventures. The similarities to the 2008 crisis are uncanny, but the current situation is potentially even more threatening. The surge in troubled assets held by CRCLOs, coupled with soaring delinquency rates, paints a troubling picture for the banking sector. Despite efforts to downplay the severity of the situation, the warning signs are clear, and regulatory authorities must act swiftly to prevent a full-blown financial meltdown. The impending financial meltdown. To better understand the situation, we need to analyze the factors that Bank of America analysts have highlighted. Rising interest rates, for instance, are wreaking havoc on the resale prices of refurbished multifamily homes and diminishing demand for office space. This decline in value has put many borrowers in a tough spot, struggling to meet their obligations. As a result, issuers of collateralized loan obligations, CLOs, the riskiest part of the financial structure, are already absorbing losses. This loss absorption by issuers is a troubling sign, signaling that the banking system is starting to bleed money. The heart of the problem lies in the CLO market, where defaults are beginning to rear their ugly heads. Loans within CLOs, typically for transitional properties, are proving difficult to offload due to slowing economic conditions. With renovations taking longer and a lack of buyers, borrowers are stuck with properties they can't sell at a profit. This predicament affects borrowers and worsens the woes of banks, which are already struggling with upside-down loan portfolios. The Federal Reserve may slash interest rates to zero in response to these mounting challenges. However, this quick fix isn't a cure-all. It merely addresses part of the problem. Even with rock-bottom interest rates, the underlying issue persists. Banks remain wary of lending. As the yield curve steepens, banks tighten lending standards further, aggravating the credit crunch. This vicious cycle threatens to push borrowers into default, further straining an already fragile financial system. Compounding these concerns are collateralized loan obligations, CLOs, which have flown under the radar for years. In 2021, fueled by ultra-low interest rates, CLO issuance surged, driven by investors seeking profits through fix-and-flip strategies. However, the pandemic-induced economic slowdown has exposed the vulnerability of these investments. Multifamily properties, a significant collateral component of CLOs, face increased vacancies as unemployment rises and tenants struggle to pay rent. The repercussions are alarming. Delinquencies in CLOs are rising, triggering safety triggers and downgrades by credit rating agencies. As losses mount, even a rate cut by the Federal Reserve may not be enough to prevent a financial catastrophe. The contagion effect, a domino waiting to fall. One of the most alarming aspects of the toxic asset crisis is its potential for contagion. This domino effect could rapidly spread across the global financial system, leaving a trail of devastation in its wake. The interconnectedness of modern financial markets means that the failure of a single institution or the implosion of a specific asset class could trigger a chain reaction as counterparties and investors alike scramble to mitigate their exposure and shore up their positions. This contagion effect was vividly demonstrated during the 2008 financial crisis, when the collapse of the U.S. housing market and the subsequent implosion of mortgage-backed securities sent shockwaves through the global financial ecosystem. Banks, investment firms, and entire nations struggled with the fallout as the intricate web of interconnected liabilities and risk exposures unraveled. The shadow banking system. Compounding the threat posed by toxic assets is the ever-expanding shadow banking system, a vast and largely unregulated network of financial intermediaries, including hedge funds, money market funds, and other non-bank entities operating outside traditional banking regulations. This shadow banking system has grown exponentially in recent years, fueled by an insatiable appetite for high-yield investments and a perception of reduced risk due to the lack of regulatory oversight. However, this perception of safety is a mirage, as the intricate web of interconnections between the shadow banking system and the traditional banking sector creates a conduit for the rapid propagation of risk and the potential for systemic shocks. As Bank of America's warning highlights, the shadow banking system represents a ticking time bomb, with the potential to amplify the impact of any financial crisis and aggravate the fallout from the implosion of toxic assets, regulatory shortcomings, and the need for reform. In the wake of the 2008 financial crisis, a wave of regulatory reform swept across the financial sector, aimed at strengthening management, enhancing transparency, and mitigating the risks posed by toxic assets and excessive power. However, as Bank of America's warning shows, these efforts have fallen short, leaving the financial system vulnerable to a repeat of the catastrophic events that brought the Great Recession. One of the key challenges lies in the nature of global financial regulations, with disparities in regulatory frameworks and enforcement mechanisms across different jurisdictions. These regulatory divisions have created opportunities for regulatory arbitrage as financial institutions seek to exploit loopholes and jurisdictional differences to their advantage. Moreover, the complexity and ingenuity of the financial services industry have outpaced the ability of regulators to keep pace, leading to a constant cat-and-mouse game where new financial products and strategies emerge faster than regulatory frameworks can adapt. To address these shortcomings, Bank of America and other industry leaders have called for a coordinated effort to strengthen regulatory frameworks, enhance transparency, and implement robust stress testing and risk management protocols. The human cost. While the impending financial crisis may seem like a distant and abstract concept limited to the halls of Wall Street and global financial centers, its ramifications have the potential to resonate across Main Street, impacting the lives and livelihoods of ordinary citizens around the world. The 2008 financial crisis served as a harsh reminder of the devastating consequences that can happen when the financial system fails. Millions of jobs were lost, homes were foreclosed, and hard-earned savings evaporated, leaving countless families grappling with the harsh realities of economic turmoil. Lessons must be learned from the past, and a joint effort must be made to decouple the fortunes of the financial sector from the well-being of ordinary citizens, ensuring that the pursuit of profit does not come at the expense of economic stability and societal welfare. Diversification and risk management, a path forward. In the face of the looming financial crisis, individuals, businesses, and institutions alike must embrace a proactive approach to risk management and diversification. The potential impact of any single event or asset implosion can be mitigated by spreading risk across a wide range of asset classes, sectors, and geographic regions. Additionally, investors must critically evaluate their exposure to potentially toxic assets, conducting rigorous due diligence and seeking professional guidance to navigate the complexities of the modern financial sector. Bank of America's warning is a stark reminder of the fragility of the global economy and the urgent need for action. The threat of a financial crisis fueled by risky assets is no longer a distant possibility, but a pressing reality. It requires cooperation from policymakers, regulators, financial institutions, and individuals. We must rethink our risk management and transparency approach to ensure sustainable growth. Ignoring this warning could have catastrophic consequences, affecting future generations and destabilizing the global economy. It's a call to action that transcends borders and ideologies. We must work together to prevent a financial crisis, preserving economic security and prosperity for all. This challenge requires courage, determination, and a commitment to responsible stewardship.